Today I'm going to talk a little bit about OIS and EIS, Optical Image Stabilization and Electronic Image Stabilization. I'll be comparing the Huawei Nexus 6P and the Samsung Galaxy S7 Edge. We know that the Nexus 6P has electronic image stabilization. If I pop off the back lens cover, you can tell that the camera unit itself is not moving at all when I rock the phone back and forth. All of its image stabilizing is done internally, electronically. Now with the Samsung Galaxy S7 Edge, when I rock the phone back and forth, you can see the camera unit compensating for the motion, like a little gyro or a camera gimbal built right into the phone. It is stabilizing with hardware and not software. Hit that thumbs up button for a beautiful circuit board.
So I have both the Galaxy S7 Edge and the Nexus 6P in front of me, stabilized with this homemade camera stabilizing rig that'll hold them both equally while I walk around. So we're going to test the OIS on the Samsung S7 Edge and the EIS on the Nexus 6P. So if I have both of my phones in front of me, how am I recording this video? Well, I'm glad you asked. This is the Galaxy Note 5, and I'm using this to record the screens on my homemade rig at the same time. It's almost like breaking the fourth wall, if you know what I mean. A little bit of camera inception.
That guy is so weird. So this is me just walking down the trail. Right now I'm filming in 4K resolution. Both the Nexus 6P and the Galaxy S7 Edge will be able to stabilize at this resolution. I'm going to try again at 1080p though, just to be sure. We're going to try a pan with the EIS and the OIS. Basically what the EIS is doing right now is it's taking the digital image and correcting it in the software as I'm filming, where the OIS is correcting it in the hardware before it even gets to the software. It's stabilizing it beforehand. I'm gonna try to run a little bit. I am holding both the cameras equally with my little rig that I put up. It's evening right now, so the light is getting a little bit lower. Both of this is being filmed with the stock camera apps on both phones. So now we've switched to 1080p. We'll see if the Nexus 6P can handle the stabilizing a little bit better. Even though the EIS option is available on 4K, it could be that it doesn't have enough pixels to work with to stabilize the image. It does look a lot smoother in 1080p. It's almost like a warp stabilizer effect that you would use in Adobe Premiere Pro while you're editing. Let's try running.
So looking again at this 4K footage, which phone is on which side? I'll let you watch for a second before I tell you. Keep in mind that there is a $200 price difference between these two phones. The 6P is about $500 and the S7 is about $700. But it is still interesting to compare the camera quality between these two Android phones. Even though the 6P has EIS turned on for shooting in 4K, it does not stabilize as well with that resolution as it does with the 1080p footage. With the hardware stabilization or OIS on the S7 Edge, it does a better job of stabilizing at all resolutions. Please subscribe for my future videos and let me know what phone you think did best in the comments below. Thanks for watching. Hope to see you around.